We, four friends, suddenly planned to visit Thailand just 1 month before the trip. It all started with late night booking tickets, booking hotels, booking cruise, taking visa photos and currency exchange. On a Friday evening after office, we took our backpack and started for Kolkata airport. Our flight, Indigo 6E77, was around 9 PM to Bangkok. The duration of the flight was around 2.5 hours. At Bangkok Suvarnabhumi Airport, we had visa on arrival for our 5-day trip. It was a long wait as a connecting flight to Phuket was around 6 AM in the local timing. It was a 2-hour flight from Bangkok to Phuket by VietJet Air. There was a taxi stand just outside Phuket Airport. There, we got tickets for shared bus and headed directly to a resort. Our pre-booked Titan Resort was just 2 km away from Patong Beach with its own unspoiled private beach. The view from the room was so refreshing that all our tiredness vanished. And without wasting any time, we quickly put on our costumes and plunged into the sea. Post-lunch, we had some rest and had a relaxing Thai massage at the resort. This was the view from balcony while sunset. In the evening, we went to Patong Beach to experience the famous nightlife. And there was this famous Bangla Road, which is a walking street with lots of beer bars, nightclubs, live music bars and rooftop bars. There we saw some jaw-dropping pole and acrobatic dance while walking on the streets. This was quite a different experience for us. Finally, we took a seat at Beer Garden, which basically serves various Thai street food with some mind-blowing performances. Hours, we went back to resort by some local tuk-tuk. Next day, we had a tour to James Bond and Hong Island by speedboat. Booking was done at the resort. It was 2000 baht per person, which included pickup from hotel and transfer to port along with refreshments and an awesome lunch. And that's a speedboat with maximum capacity of 25 passengers. This is Phanka Bay, a shallow bay with dramatic views of the colourful limestone cliffs with caves. This spectacular view was of James Bond Island, which is famous for the movie The Man with the Golden Gun. The island itself is very scenic and an ideal frame for clicking photos. Here's the unwanted surprise. The place is full of vendors selling all kinds of souvenirs. Then comes the exciting part, canoeing through the caves of Phanka Bay. Each inflatable canoe carries 2 people with a guide. Some of the places were so narrow that we literally had to lay back. But it was fun. Next was our lunch stop at Kopani Island. This place is entirely built on stilts by Muslim Indonesian fishermen. The village has a Muslim school and a floating football beach. We had lunch in one of the seafood restaurants. Did some shopping from stalls selling souvenirs. Our last destination of this day trip was Naka Island, where we did swimming and jet skiing. At around 5:30 PM, they dropped us to the hotel. So to enjoy the spectacular view of unspoiled nature, one must have this one-day trip. and don't forget to carry swimwear, sunglasses and sunblocks. Next day morning, we checked out from hotel as we had planned to stay overnight at Phi Phi Island. The cruise was pre-booked online from Andaman Ferry Service website. At around 7:30 a.m, they picked us from Triton Beach Resort. The Andaman Webmaster cruise was from Phuket Rasata Pier to Phi Phi Tonsai Pier. It took around 2 hours. Initially, we had booked economy class tickets online, but manually upgraded to premium class on board. It was quite spacious and bright with free refreshments. Yes, it was a big boat with carrying capacity of 450 people, but the overall experience was good. Weather was good and the view once we were near Phi Phi Island was beautiful. We were surprised after seeing series of hotel-specific long-tail boats waiting to pick up guests. Online, we had booked Paradise Beach Resort for our overnight stay. And this was our boat, waiting for us to take directly to resort. It was quite surprising. It took roughly 10 minutes. The resort was right on the beach. The view was amazing. You can see the waves. For that, it was a bit tricky to get down from the boat. As it was just an overnight stay, we quickly asked the resort to arrange for a half-day trip by long-tail boat for only 4 of us. And within no time, the boat was ready for us. And we started heading towards that island over there. That's Viking Cave. As tourists are not allowed here, we just passed by the cave. This place is ideal for snorkeling. You can see many tourist boats. Our resort provided all snorkeling gears. So without wasting any time, we just jumped into the water. It was an awesome experience with so many colorful fish and corals visible clearly in the water, as if we were inside an aquarium. But one must know how to swim to enjoy snorkeling here. The water was so transparent that the colorful fishes were visible from outside only. It was really a bliss for our eyes as the sea color kept on changing in various shades of blue. As Maya Bay is closed for tourists, we managed to see this famous beach from a distance. While heading back, again we stopped for snorkeling. So in the same day, we did snorkeling thrice. We really felt accomplished after doing this half-day trip. The day was a bit hectic, but at night we had a lovely dinner at the seaside hotel. Next day morning, after a relaxing Thai massage, we checked out and the long-tail boat dropped us at the port to board the cruise back to Phuket. Then directly we headed to Phuket Airport and came back to Bangkok. At Bangkok, it was just an overnight stay at the Ambassador Hotel. And next day, we did some quick shopping and headed back to the airport. And with this, our trip ends. Thanks for watching.